eat.
Oh, Mary, don't expect me for dinner. I've got to pack.
But what happened?
Oh, Mary, when I get back, I'm going to do everything John says.
Oh, good.
Oh, my Serenity.
Listen, sister, when are you going to get wise to yourself?
Who, me?
Yeah, you.
Why, I was divorced this morning, Miriam.
Oh, a Reno divorce. Hello? No, operator, we completed that call. Mary, listen to me.
There's nothing you can say that I haven't heard.
Sure? Maybe I got a new slant. I come from a world where a woman's gotta come out on top, or it's just too darn bad.
All right, Miriam, talk to me all you want. But what does it come to? Compromise.
Well, what the heck? A woman's compromised the day she's born.
Can't compromise without a defeat. He doesn't want me.
How do you know?
Well, I've waited every day to hear from him.
Did you write to him?
Of course not.
How do you know he hasn't been waiting, too? Listen, honey, I've been through all this before. You know, I lost my man, too.
You?
It only happened once. Got wise to myself after that. Look, how did I lose him? We didn't have enough dough to get married, and I wouldn't... Well, I had my pride. Heaven knows where I got it. I liked him a lot better than I've ever liked anybody since. And what did my Romeo do one day? He took a little walk out on me. I made a terrible row. Why shouldn't I? I should. But what I ought not to have done was to have run away and leave him in the clutches of that woman, like a coward. That's what you are, Mary Haines. You're a blithering coward.
Why? Because I wouldn't stay and be second fiddle?
Because you ran out of the trenches under fire. You deserted him.
I deserted him?
Well, sure you did. You don't think he wants to be in the grip of that red-headed octopus, do you? I bet if you'd given him half a chance, he'd have asked you not to get this divorce.
Well, why, Miriam, he did ask me.
And you still ran away?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, listen, honey. Don't you know that we dames have got to be a lot more to the guy we marry than a schoolgirl sweetheart? We got to be a wife, a real wife. And a mother, too, and a pal. Yeah, and a nursemaid. Sometimes when it comes to the point, we've even got to be a cutie. You should have licked that girl where she licked you. In his arms. That's where you win in the first round. And if I know men, it's still Custer's last stand. Shocked you? Okay, sister. But my idea of love is that love isn't ashamed of nothing.
Oh, that's easy enough to say, Miriam. But that girl's in his blood, huh? I couldn't have stayed under the same roof with him and faced that.
Well, why not? Suppose the guy had smallpox. You wouldn't like to have faced that either, would you? But you'd have done it, wouldn't you?
Yes.
Oh, honey, this jam that he's in would make a bad case of smallpox look like a carnival. So while the poor guy's floundering around helpless, you remove the one protection he's got, his legal marriage. So he's back there, stumbling around in the open, delirious and unprotected, with a she-wolf in lamb's clothing right on his heels. And not one word of comfort out of you. Because why? Because you're too busy nursing your two-for-a-nickel pride. Operator, we completed it. You say it's New York calling Mrs. Haines? It's Mr. Haines? Tell him you'll tear that divorce decree into a million pieces and use it for confetti.
Hello? Hello, Stephen?